Now focusing specifically on Cisco Software Defined Access or Cisco SDA. So Cisco Software Defined Access is this technology uses the software defined approach to manage or build a wired or wireless local area network. With the help of this SDA technology, with the help of this software defined access technology, we can have a centralized controller somewhere in our network, and we would design the network in such a way that every aspect of that network, like the devices we have used in that network, could be managed with the help of that centralized controller. Now, this controller is in fact the DNS center controller, or in short, we call that DNAC. So there's still going to be some sort of physical network based on the router switches devices, like based on different devices. There is still going to be some physical network. But these devices that we have here, they are going to be managed with the help of this centralized controller that we are using in our LAN environment called DNA Center. So we will be using we can use in fact some apps, some third-party applications. We can take the GUI access of this DNS Center controller. The apps could be natively provided by the Cisco, or some other vendors can create the apps, and we can run those apps on a separate system and all. And we can also run different scripts, like automation thing is also available. So all these things are basically present in this SDA environment. Now, when we talk about the architecture of the software defined access, there are total three things that you must consider. One is SDA underlay, one is SDA overlay, and finally, we have the SDA fabric. So these are three things that you will see architecturally from the architecture point of view. You will see the three things that will be used in the SDA is something called underlay, overlay, and the fabric. Now you can think of the underlay as the actual underlying infrastructure. Actual underlying infrastructure, where like we have routers, we have switches, the actual physical infrastructure that we have, actual physical devices, cablings, and everything. We might run some protocols internally. So all that thing is basically going to be part of the underlay. Underlay is basically like a collection of devices, cables. Devices could be like router, switches, basically wired devices, wireless devices, and all. So underlay is the actual underlying network on the top of which the overlay, a logical network, is built. So on the top of the underlay network, a logical network is built, and that a logical network is what we call as overlay. Okay. So in this overlay network, you might see a variety of tunnels being built, and we call those tunnels as a VXLAN tunnel. Okay, just like we build the tunnels in a real-time environment, we might create some sort of bridge. Maybe let's say this is a road where very heavy traffic passes through, and what we can do, we can build a bridge over that so that the people from here can go there. Similar to that, you can consider this underlay overlay network in the same way. Let's say you have, for example, a switch here, you have a switch here, and in between these two, there are other devices. Let's consider them switches itself. There are different switches here. They might be connected in whatever fashion you might want to connect. Okay, they are connected like that, for example. Now, the user is here, and the user wants to go there. So this actual topology that we have, this actual network that we have, it is what we are going to call as underlay. This is the underlay network. It includes variety of switches, variety of cables, routers, and wired wireless devices, and everything. Now, when we talk about the overlay, when we configure the SDA in our network, what will happen that these switches, let's say the traffic has to go from this particular source to this particular destination, A to B. So what will happen is that whenever the traffic is intended to go from A to B, traffic will be received on the switch number one. Switch number one is going to use some sort of a logical tunnel, which is built end to end, which is built from switch one to switch two. A logical tunnel, a logical connection. A tunnel is nothing, just the logical connection between two endpoints, like this. Like this logical tunnel is built up between the switch one and switch two. This logical tunnel, which is built up between switch one and switch two. And this is what we are going to call as the VXLAN tunnel. This tunnel is built up with the help of the technology called VXLAN, which is, you might have already heard of the VLAN. So virtual extensible local area network, we call that VXLAN here. So this logical tunnel will be built between the sender switch and the receiver switch here. And that tunnel will be based on the VXLAN technology. So this is going to be overlay. This is a logical network which is built between the switch one and switch two over the top of the underlay. So underlay is the actual underlying network, and overlay is the logical network which is built on the top of the underlay. Okay. Now, combining all these two, like a combination of underlay and overlay all together, which provides the data delivery across all the interfaces or across the network, we call that fabric. So SDA fabric consists of the underlay and overlay both. The SDA fabric, when we talk about the terminology fabric is nothing, just the it is a combination of SDA underlay and the overlay. Combining both, we call this the SDA fabric. Together, it is going to provide the features, all the features that are required to deliver the data across the network. Okay. Now, different type of devices can be placed in the SDA. Like specifically talking about the underlay devices. If I specifically talk about the underlay devices, so we can have like different switches. We can have different routers. Obviously, these routers, these switches, these wireless devices, they must support the software-defined access technology. Like you might either have to upgrade the network, upgrade the switch, router, wireless devices, upgrade their operating system to support the underlay, otherwise purchase a new device. Okay. Means if you are having some sort of existing network, you are having the existing network, you can migrate the devices of that network into software defined access network. What you have to do is that you have to migrate the operating system of all those devices to support the SDA. And if, just in case, if your device does not support the SDA, you have to replace that device with the SDA compatible device. You can visit cisco.com/go/SDA to check the compatibility list for the same. Basically, like the devices must meet some minimum requirement before they can become the part of the SDA network. Okay. Now, these devices that we have placed here, these devices are going to be assigned different roles. Basically, the devices are going to have separate roles in the SDA fabric. There are major three type of devices you will see in the underlay network. One device that you will see in the underlay network is what we call as a fabric edge node. The fabric edge node is basically, you know, it is just a device on your SDN fabric, typically a switch that connects to the endpoint. This endpoint could be PC or it could be a server or anything like that. So any node that connects to the endpoint, server or wireless access point, for example. So any device that connects to the endpoint, it is what we call as fabric edge node. A switch that connects to the endpoint devices, just like in the traditional networking, we have the access layer switches. Similar to that, we have here fabric edge node. Okay. Second type of devices that we have in our SDA fabric is what we call fabric border node. Second type of devices that we have, we call them fabric border node. So this is a switch, basically. This is switch number four. This is a switch that connects to the device outside the SDA fabric. So let's say this is a switch and this is my SDA fabric. This is my SDA fabric. Okay. And in the SDA fabric, we have different devices like 1, 2, 3, all these different devices are there. And this is the device which connects to a device that is outside the SDA control. For example, a device that connects to a WAN router, for example, which is leading us towards the data center infrastructure. So a device which connects to the other device, which is not under the SDA control. So that type of device is what we are going to call as fabric border node. And finally, there is a device called fabric control node. This fabric control node is a device, it is a switch that performs some special tasks. It is going to be a switch of your network. This switch is going to perform some special control plane tasks, such as mapping and everything. We'll talk about mapping and everything later on. But this is a switch in the network that performs some special control plane functions for the underlay. Again, it requires comparatively like more CPU memory and everything. So three types of devices typically you will see into your fabric. Fabric edge node connects to the endpoints. Border node connects to a device outside the SDA control, and the control node, which is responsible to perform some specific functions. And it requires, it is responsible to perform some control plane functions, and it requires higher memory and higher CPU. Okay. Now, whenever you design the SDA in your network, anytime you want to design the SDA network, either you can have a greenfield deployment or you can have a brownfield deployment. There are some advantages of using the greenfield deployment or the brownfield deployment. You know, for example, if you have to set up a network brand new, you have to purchase all the devices like brand new. You don't have any existing infrastructure. So whenever you purchase new hardware to support the or to design the SDA network, that type of deployment is what we call as greenfield deployment. In the greenfield deployment of the SDA, we purchase all the hardware and everything brand new. Basically, we do not have any existing infrastructure. We are setting up the things from the very scratch. And this is obviously going to eliminate a lot of challenges. Like we don't need to worry what devices are compatible with what devices. Is the DNS center is going to be compatible with this existing access points or not. All those things are going to be eliminated when we talk about a very new deployment of the SDA. We have to go to the Cisco website, and there we can check the compatibility list, and based on that we are going to order the devices. Now, when we talk about the greenfield deployment, you have to consider a few things. Like, for example, the switch that you are having or the switch that you are going to connect into your SDA environment, how many number of ports are required into that switch? You have to consider that. Those ports are going to have how much speed? You have to consider that. Gigabit, 10 gig, 40 gig. Do we need any sort of stacking technology for the switches? What type of cables we have to install? What is going to be the length of the cables? Do we need power over Ethernet technology for those switches? Do we need PoE switches or do we need normal switches? The number of links, how much amount of data you have to transfer, and based on that, how many links are going to be required for the same. So a lot of things you must consider before you purchase a very new gear or you set up a very new SDA environment. However, in the brownfield deployment, you already have your existing network. You have to make necessary changes. Like you might have to upgrade from one protocol to other. You might have to, when you talk about the existing network. You might already be having like different switches and routers and the access points in your network. Now you have to check if they are compatible with that DNS Inter appliance or not. So if they are compatible, you have to upgrade the operating system, you have to upgrade the code of the device, and then you will try to manage all those things from a centralized point. So there are going to be some obvious challenges in the brownfield deployment, because you already have your network setup and now you have to make the necessary changes to support the SDK. Okay. Now, as far as the design is concerned, traditionally what we used to do is that we have a switch. Let's say we have a few switches. Let's say we have a total of 3 switches right here. And here the end user is attached. So what we used to have in earlier days in the traditional network, what we used to do is that if you remember, this is going to be, this could be like layer 3 switches. This is layer 3 switch, layer 3 switch. It is a layer 2 switch. Here we can do the ether channel bundling, STP is running, DTP is running. Okay, some device will become the root bridge and everything. So this, for this device, like what we could be doing, like we here, these are the L3 switches. We might be running HSRP there. So one is going to have the IP address, for example, 10.1.1.1. One is going to have the IP address 10.1.1.2. Then I will use a virtual IP as a default gateway onto my machine, like 10.1.1.100 maybe. So the point is that in the traditional network, you have a lot of protocols, like you have STP, you have Ether channel, you have HSRP, you have a lot of protocols to support your traditional network. A lot of overhead is also there because of these protocols. In the software-defined access network, network is not designed in this way. In the SDA, we have the switches, like this is switch number 1. Still, it is connected with the switch number 2 with these 2 cables. And here we have switch number 3, and they are still bundled all together, but it is not a layer 2 ether channel, it is a layer 3 ether channel, We are running a routing protocol in the SDA underlay. You will see the use of the protocol called ISIS, intermediate system to intermediate system. This machine that we have connected here, it is going to have the default gateway set as 10.1.1.1, which in fact is the IP address of here. So when we talk about the SDA underlay, in the SDA underlay, you will see SDA layer 3 fabric. If you see, like, we do not need the protocol such as HSRP. We do not need the protocol such as STP, RSTP. Those protocols are no longer needed because it is no longer a layer 2 fabric. It is no longer a layer 2 topology. It is a pure layer 3 topology. In fact, this all switches are layer 3 switches. In fact, this switch is also a layer 3 switch. They are reachable with the help of some IP address to each other and to the centralized controller, which is known as the DNS Inter appliance. So if you compare the SDA fabric with the traditional fabric, in the traditional network, a lot of layer 2 protocols will be running. However, the only protocol you will see in the SDA is the ISIS. ISIS is responsible to provide the IP connectivity between the devices running in the underlay. ISIS is very much similar to the OSPF. Both are the link state routing protocol. Why we need link state routing protocol here? So that we can have the entire topological map on all these switches, so that they can choose a proper path from the source to the destination. Anyway, so ISIS is the choice of the protocol used in the SDA underlay. Okay. Now, since as you might have guessed, like, since the things are moving towards the software-defined infrastructure, we no longer require the protocol such as STP, HSRP. There's no need to study in detail about those protocols, because if everyone or most of the people in the world, they jump into the SDA, there will not be requirement of any such protocol. However, SDA is not that much easily available nowadays. It might be in near future, but not as of now. SDA technology is not easily accessible for every enterprise network, so they still be using the traditional network where they would require these protocol like L2 protocols, HTTP, VTP, DTP, and everything. But here, a lot of overhead gets reduced automatically. All the switches are layer 3 switches. They are reachable to each other with the help of the ISIS protocol. Bundling is there. The Ether channel bundling is there, and that bundling is a layer 3 bundling. And STP, RSTP is not needed. HSRP and everything is not needed. The access layer device typically, which is what we are going to call in the SDA terminology, Fabric Edge Node is acting as the gateway for the same. So all these things are basically there. All these things are part of the SDA vendor.